I'm Bella Dubois. My father is Maurice Dubois. And, I'm here to offer my services to the prince.
My advice to you is to get out while you still can.
No. Please, take me to the prince.
Come in. Follow me.
Yes.
So, you would be the daughter of old Dubois. Jerome failed to inform me that you were a mere child.
I'm not a child, my lord.
Let me see your hands. I want to feel them. These hands have never done a day's housework.
My sister's always done that.
Well, then it's your sister I want. If old Dubois wanted to dump on us another mouth to feed, he's misjudged me.
No. It was my own choice. I will work for you.
It won't last a day.
Try me.
You are no daughter of our Maurice's. He's always so wishy-washy. It's not a fluke that he's a failure. I would hazard another explanation. Your mother must have been quite friendly with one of his sailors. Or more than one.
This way. Tomorrow at dawn, they'll be expecting you in the kitchen.
Can you cook?
A little.
Embroider. Anne?
No.
The servant who knows how to do nothing. May I please know what I'm expected to do with her?
Well, there is always the cellar.
The prince wants it tidied up before the harvest.
Which is when?
Tomorrow.
Thank you. I done to you?
Don't worry about me. I'm fine.
No, no, no. Not in the least. You're coming home with me right now.
No, no. No, you mustn't lose the Bonne Espérance.
It's only a ship.
But it's your ship. And that ship is your life. And one day will be mine, too. Father.
Captain Dubois! This is my property.
I want to talk to you.
Did you bring me the money you owe me?
No.
Teach him a lesson. And then kick him out.
Wait, wait, wait. I have something better to offer. It's the deed to the Bonne Espérance.
Father, please, no.
You chose to hand over your daughter. My former offer is no longer valid.
That's not all. I'll remain in your service on the Bonne Espérance as long as I live. No one knows her like I do. In this way, not only would I cancel my debt, but also I'd handle all your trading for you until the crew throws my dead body overboard. The only thing I ask is that you free my daughter.
What about if we let her decide? This is your last chance. Grab it before I change my mind.
It's with me that you have an agreement. I shall serve you until my father has paid off all his debt. But not an écru more.
No, 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 no. Don't listen to her. Take the ship.
Listen, Father. Keep doing what you love. Get Evelyn her dowry. And one day, you will pay off all the debt. And you will bring me home.
No. No, you can't.
I can take care of myself, Father. Don't worry.
You will regret it.
I know I will.
Young girl.
What young girl?
The latest servant to arrive.
Oh, a mere servant.
A servant who held her own with you, and very handily.
She's only a child that wanted to show off in front of her father.
She's no longer a child, judging from the way you looked at her.
I can have any woman I want. I certainly don't need to chase after some scullery maid.
Any woman, yes. But her? I wouldn't think so. She's too proud, and she'll never betray her father's trust.
They say that about all of you. Until you grant your favors to the first stable boy who swaggers by.
Of course. If we imagine we're in love with him. But that girl doesn't seem to meet the type to offer herself in exchange for some empty fantasy.
Three weeks. Give me 3 weeks, and you will find her in my bed. And at that point, she will no longer indeed be a child.
Would you be willing to bet on that?
If I won, would you accept the Baron's proposal?
Yes. But if you lose, then it's you who must propose to me.
It won't happen, but if it were to, you would never be happy with me.
But it's not happiness I want, Leon. It's you.
I'm sorry, for I shall have Bella. And you have no one.
Answer me.
What are you doing here? Feeling lonesome?
Did you hear it too last night?
If you're awake at night, it means you're not working hard enough during the day.
I was trying to rest, but those cries frightened me. Do you know something that you're not telling me?
Some nights we hear that.
Corinne!
She might as well know it. Why not?
Know what?
We think it's the ghost of the prince's wife.
The prince was married?
To Princess Juliet. I knew her. I was already in service with Countess Helene.
How did she die?
There was a fire. To escape, the princess jumped from a window.
Too bad her clothing showed no signs of burning.
Corinne, that will do. Go upstairs. I'm sure you have something to see to.
Bella. The prince wants you.
Do something wrong.
With him, you never know.
My lord, you asked for me. Can I do something for you?
I should ask you that. Thanks to you, I shall be able to store today's harvest in these ancient barrels, and our wine will be extraordinary.
I only did as I was told.
But with a zeal like no one else. Allow me to offer you a taste. It's just pressed.
No, thank you. It's better if I don't.
Oh, come on. It's just juice. No alcohol at all. Not dangerous.
Not yet. But it will be. Excuse me, but they're waiting for me in the kitchen.
Bella? That's your name, isn't it? Do you know how to read? They've been lying ignored here for many years. I could use your zeal to catalog and organize them all in proper order. Can you manage it? A book remains just a book. Doesn't get dangerously intoxicating over time. Shall I take that as a yes?
I'll do it in my free time. I don't want the others to think that I'm being given special treatment.
You know how one would receive special treatment?
Oh, please, I don't want to. It's
by
just...
finding a good cookbook in here and giving it to Albertine. Oh, you have no idea how that would improve my life.